Hello students, today we are going to continue with the third prose, that is the nightingale and the rose. In the last lecture we had seen how the nightingale was trying to get the red rose for the boy and what condition was given by a rose tree to the nightingale for getting the red rose from it. We'll start. The young student was still lying on the grass where she had left him, and the tears were not yet dry in his beautiful eyes. Means when the red rose had flew to get the nightingale has flew to get the red rose for the boy, after she comes from the rose tree, after she speaks to the rose tree and come there, she sees the boy still lying there on the grass and he's still weeping. "Be happy," cried the nightingale. "Be happy. You shall have your red rose." The nightingale is trying to console the boy. It is saying that be happy, don't cry. You will get the red rose. You will get the red rose which you want to give to your beloved. "I will build it out of music by moonlight and the stain with my own heart's blood." The nightingale is saying that I am going to build a red rose for you in the moonlight and I will give my blood to the rose plant so that it grows a red rose on it. "All that I ask of you in return is that you will be a true lover, for love is wiser than philosophy. Though she is wise and mightier than power, though he is mighty." Now the nightingale is saying to the boy that I only want one thing from you. I want assurance from you that you will be a true lover, because love is wiser than philosophy. "Flame colored are his wings, and colored like flame is his body. His leaves are sweet as honey, and his breath is like frankincense." The student looked up from the grass and listened, but he could not understand what the nightingale was saying to him, for he only knew the things that are written down in books. Means now when the nightingale was saying all these things to the boy didn't understand anything. He just stood up in the grass there. And because this boy only understood about the things which are written in the books. He doesn't understand anything. But the oak tree understood and felt very sad. But the tree understood what the nightingale was saying, and it felt very sad for the nightingale, for he was very fond of the little nightingale who had built her nest in his branches. Because this oak tree was very fond of the nightingale whose nest was in its branches. "Sing me one last song," he whispered. "I shall feel very lonely when you are gone." The oak tree is saying, it is requesting nightingale to sing a song, one last song for him, because it will feel very lonely when it is not there, when it will die. So the nightingale sang to the oak tree, and her voice was like water bubbling from a silver jar. Means that it was very, you can say, musical, very nice voice. When she had finished the song, the student got up and pulled a notebook and lead pencil out of his pocket. Means when the nightingale finished her song, this boy has got up and he just pulled a notebook and a lead pencil out of his pocket. "She has foam," he said to himself, and he walked away through the wood. "That cannot be denied to her. But has she got feeling? I am afraid not. In fact, she is like the most artist. She is all style, without any sincerity. She would not sacrifice herself for others. She thinks merely of music, and everybody knows that the arts are selfish. Still, it must be admitted that she has some beautiful notes in her voice. What a pity is it? It is that they do not mean anything, or they do any practical good." As he went into the room and lay down on his little pallet bed, pallet means bed made of mattresses, and began to think of his love, after a time he fell asleep. Means he's thinking about the nightingale, he's saying that though it has a nice voice, it can sing nicely, it cannot do anything because no one will sacrifice their life for someone else and all. He thinks and he just gets up from there and he goes and sleeps in his room. And when the moon shone in the heavens, the nightingale flew to the rose tree. And when the moon was shining in the heaven, the nightingale flies to the rose tree and set her breast against the thorn. She sets her breast against the thorn. All night long she sang with her breast against the thorn. See how painful it would be. Throughout the night, her breast was against the thorn and it was singing. The cold crystal moon leaned down and listened. All things in nature were listening to it. All night long she sang, and the thorn went deeper and deeper into her breast. As she was singing, the thorn was getting deeper into the breast, and her life blood ebbed away from her. Means it was becoming less and less from her body and getting into the veins of the rose plant. She sang first of the birth of love in her heart of a boy and a girl. Means first she was singing about the birth of love in the heart of boy and a girl. Means how they felt love for each other. And on the topmost spray of the rose tree, there blossomed a marvelous red rose. Means now when she was singing throughout the night, a red rose blossoms on the rose tree. Petal following petal as song followed song. Means as she was going on singing, the flower rose plant was growing. The flower rose was growing. Pain was it at first at the mist that hangs over the river. Pain as the feet of the morning and the silver as the wings of the dawn. First when it grew on the rose plant, it was pale in color. As the shadow of a rose in a mirror of silver, as the shadow of a rose in water pool, so was the rose that blossomed on the topmost spray of the tree. I mean, it was very pale in color. But the tree cried to the night, cried to the nightingale to press closer against the thorn. But still the tree was trying to tell the nightingale that press your breast against the thorn very much, so that the veins get the red color from your blood. Press closer, little nightingale, cried the tree, or the day will come before the rose is finished. Means it is saying, press before the day comes. So, and then if the rose is grown on the tree, it will be of that color only. If you give more blood, then only it will become red rose. So the nightingale pressed closer against the thorn, the louder and louder grew her song. For she sang of birth of passion in the soul of a man and a maid. Means then again she started singing song after song because she wanted the red rose to get red in color. Now she was singing about the passion in the soul of a man and a maid for each other. A story. And a delicate flush of pink came into the leaves of the rose. Now the leaves become pinkish in color. Like the flush in the face of a bridegroom when he kisses the lips of the bride. But the thorn had not yet reached her heart. So the rose heart remained white. For only a nightingale's heart blood can crimson the heart of the rose. But still, the heart of the rose has not got the blood of the nightingale, because only the blood of nightingale's heart can make the heart of rose red in color. Crimson means what? Deep red color. And the tree cried to the nightingale to press closer against the thorn. Press closer, little nightingale, cried the tree, or the day will come before the rose is finished. Means the rose tree is continuously saying to nightingale, you press your breast closer to the thorn so that it get the blood. Because if the day arises, then you will not, the rose will be ready and it will be of not red color. So the nightingale pressed closer against the thorn, and the thorn touched her heart, and a fierce pang of pain shot through her. Bitter, bitter was the pain, and wilder, wilder grew her song. For she sang of the love that is perfected by death, of the love that dies not in the tomb. Means, here now she is pressing herself breast closer to the thorn so that it get red blood for the heart of the red rose. And because of that, it has caused lot of pain to her. And because of pain, she was singing more wilder and wilder. She was singing about the love that is perfected by death. Means, to just get a love for someone, someone can give life also. That she wanted to tell through her song. And the love that dies not in tomb. She wanted to tell that only, that love, it is like a sacrifice which we give for someone. It is not that which we die in the tomb. And the marvelous rose became crimson. And finally, what happened? The rose becomes red in color, like the rose of the eastern sky. Crimson was the girdle of petals, means belt of the petals. And crimson as the ruby was the heart, means it became very red in color. But the nightingale voice grew fainter. Now because all the blood from the nightingale's body has gone into the red rose. So her voice has become fainter now. It has become low and her little wings began to beat. And a film came over her eyes. Means everything starts going from her, from in front of her eyes. Now she is about to die. Fainter and fainter grew her song. And she felt something choking in her throat. Means she felt like now she is going to die. Then she gave one last burst of music. The white moon heard it and she forgot the dawn and lingered on in the sky. The red rose heard it and it trembled all over with ecstasy. Means intense pleasure, because now it has grown into a good red color rose. And it opens, and the red rose opened its petal to the cold morning air. The echo bore it to her purple cavern in the hills and woke the sleeping shepherds from their dreams. It floated through the reeds of the river and they carried its message to the sea. But what happened? The nightingale has died now. Means it just flew and it was just, you can say, now given up its life for the red rose. And now this red rose has blossomed very nicely. Look, look, cried the tree. The rose is finished now. But the nightingale made no answer. Now the tree is saying, see her, the red rose has grown on it. But the nightingale was no more, so it could not answer. For she was lying dead in the long grass with the thorn in her heart. But she was dead. At noon, the student opened his window and looked out. Why want a wonderful piece of luck? Why, what a wonderful piece of luck, he cried. Here is a red rose. I have never seen any rose like it in all my life. It is so beautiful that I am sure it has a long Latin name. And he leaned down and plucked it. But when the boy, he woke up, when he saw the red rose in his garden near the window, he was very surprised. He said to himself that he has never seen such a beautiful red rose like this one. Then he put on his hat and ran up to the professor's house with the rose in his hand. He just plucked it and ran to professor's house. The daughter of the professor was sitting in a doorway, winding the blue silk on a reel, and her little dog was lying at her feet. Means when he went there, he saw that the girl was sitting near the doorway and winding the blue silk on reel, and the dog was lying at her feet. You said that you would dance with me if I brought you a red rose, cried the student. The boy told her that you demanded me to get a red rose for you, then only you will dance with me. Here is the reddest rose in all the world. You will wear it to the night. You will wear it tonight next to your heart, and we, as we dance together, it will tell you how I love you. He's saying, see, I've got the reddest rose for you. It is the reddest of all rose in the world. And I want you to wear it next to your heart in the party and we both will dance together. It will also tell you that how much I love you. But the girl frowned, means she became very angry. I am afraid it will not go with my dress. She's saying that it will not match with my dress. And besides, the chamberlain's nephew have sent me some real jewels and everybody knows that jewels cost far more than flowers. Now what she's saying, that chamberlain's nephew has sent some real jewels and everyone knows that jewelry is more precious than flowers. So I am going to wear that jewelry, I won't be wearing your red rose. Well, upon my word, you are very ungrateful, said the student angrily. He got very angry with her that first you demanded me to bring a red rose, so I bought it for you. And now, after so much trouble, when I bought it for you, you are saying that the jewelry is more precious than flower. So he got very angry and he threw the rose into the street. Where it fell into the gutter and a cart wheel went over it. See how bad. The nightingale has given the life for the red rose. And now this girl is very ungrateful. She has opted or she has chosen jewelry over the red rose. But this boy, he also in a fit of anger, he has thrown the rose into the street near the gutter and a cartwheel has also gone over it. Ungrateful, said the girl. I tell you what, you are very rude. And after all, who are you? Only a student? Why, I don't believe you have even got silver buckles to your shoes as the chamberlain's nephew has. And she got up from her chair and went into the house. She is saying that you are very ungrateful and who are you? You are of no worth here. She is saying that you don't have even silver buckles to your shoes and this mother man, the chamberlain's nephew, is very rich. He has given jewels to me as a gift and you cannot give me anything. And she just got up from her chair and she went into the house. What a silly thing love is, said the student as he walked away. When this boy was going back to his house, he say, love is such a silly thing. It can change, so quickly. It is not half as useful as logic, for it does not prove anything. It is always telling one of things that are not going to happen and making one believe things are that not true. Means it is saying that the boy is saying to himself that love is not of any logic. Here you cannot tell that what can happen the next moment. One moment you can feel love for someone and next moment you can say that you don't love that person. In fact, it is quite unpracticable. And it is in this age to be practical is everything. I shall go back to philosophy and study metaphysics. And this boy is saying, love is really a nonsense thing and I have wasted my time over this love. I wasted my precious time. My age is to study here. So I am going to forget about everything and I am going to study my metaphysics now. So he returned to his room and pulled out a great dusty book and began to read. Means here, what happened? He finally realizes that the love is nothing. Means to be practical in life is very correct here. And what happened? He forgets everything and he starts with his study. So here, student, we have seen that Oscar Wilde, he has really nicely explored the theme of compassion, sacrifice, and top of that, love. In his story, it was really interesting story. I hope you have understood. Go through it. Thank you.